सक्सेस फील है ना, हम आई एंजॉय इट। मेरी शक्ल से क्या लग रहा है आपको? यार अब आई एम वेरी वेरी हैप्पी बिकॉज़ आफ्टर आई मेट ऑल ऑफ यू ऑल एवरीबॉडी सेड यू नो इट्स अ रिस्क, इट्स एन एक्सपेरिमेंट, दिस काइंड ऑफ रोल, इट्स अ हीरो दैट एंड व्हेन द ऑडियंस कम्स एंड गिव्स यू दैट लव, यू आर वैलिडेटेड ना, यू फील। अच्छा बैठ जाना। When the audience gives you that love, you genuinely feel validated कि जो मैं script select कर रहा हूँ वो सही जा रही है।
audio.
अच्छा मैं बात करूँ कि नहीं करूँ? है audio है आपके पास? आ रहा है ना? हाँ तो अगर आप सब बात करेंगे तो मैं इनसे कैसे बात करूँगा? आप सब आराम से, ये better है। Thank you. So, I felt very happy about the fact that the audience has validated even what I liked about the script. That is, they're connecting with the characters, they're finding the story endearing. There's a lot of positivity that has come out from the audience saying, you know, life should be a bit more like this. So, there's a nice shine to the story, and the audience has caught on to that. I've always been told not to do things that I've done and I've pulled off. So, I'm very happy about this being another feather in my cap that way. Mujhe sabne bola tha actor mat bano, ban gaya. मुझे सबने बोला रोमांटिक पिक्चर मत करना, टू स्टेट्स की चल गई। सबने बोला टीवी बिल्कुल मत करना, होस्ट नहीं कर पाओगे, मैंने किया, चल गया। फिर मुझे बोला भाई तुम तो एक्शन हीरो हो, तुम घर कैसे संभालोगे, कुकिंग वुकिंग तुमको शोभा नहीं देगा, कैसा रोल है ये, कर दिया, चिपक गया, ऑडियंस को पसंद आया। दस प्रूविंग इट्स गुड टू बी एन अंडरडॉग समटाइम्स बिकॉज़ यू शुड नो दैट यू आर केपेबल ऑफ डूइंग सर्टेन थिंग्स एंड यू कैन पुल इट ऑफ।
बाकी साहब अभी क्या फीलिंग्स हैं आपके भीतर, क्योंकि जिस स्टेज तक अभी फिल्म पहुंची है और जो कमाई की है अभी तक, उसके विषय में जरा बताएं।
फीलिंग्स वेरी वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स फीलिंग्स, but it's I'm happy that people have liked the film, and it's lovely to kind of see the film with the audience in the theaters. You know, we all have very many intellectual takes on the film, saying it is this and it is that, but the audience just goes to see an entertaining film and they're having great fun with it. It's not a film that's there to kind of make a statement or a, you know, it's not a documentary, it's an entertaining film, and that's what I think the audience went to see, and they got it. That's what really you love, when they get exactly what you wanted them to get. No, there's no reference. I mean, why do you need a reference like that? Because there is no reference for when the man gives the money to the woman. I mean, everybody does it. Because we don't see so many people doing it, we think it can't be done. It's very possible. I'm sure there are a lot of homes where, husbands are at home and the wife gives the money to kind of spend. I'm sure there are a lot of homes. So it's not inspired by any story. I'm assuming that's a very normal thing in a lot of households. Very many. In fact, I was just telling Arjun the other day, I'm not on social media, I'm not on Twitter or Facebook, so I get only messages. So, and I've got some phenomenal number of messages, and all the films put together, I've not got so many messages, which is scary also. But most overwhelming thing, somebody told me yesterday, I can only remember the recent ones which happened. Somebody said, at last there is a man who understands an alpha woman. First, I don't know what an alpha woman was first, so it just took me a little time to kind of get it. I said, yeah, because women who are aggressive and ambitious need not be men. They can be women. They also have a heart, they have the sensitivity. You don't have to lose everything, because she's an alpha woman. So they don't have to lose all this stuff. So I never thought of it like that. I just thought of it like the story of two people. Why would a person lose the sensitivity if somebody wants to do something? They're just two human beings. Two good human beings, when they get together, they have the usual problems. No, no, I can't, because I still haven't understood the phenomenon really well.
Sorry?
Yeah, yeah. You want me to answer that?
Sir, we all can answer it.
You
hear the first year of polite one, then I give you the right.
No, like, yeah, my most well-reviewed film is Finding Fanny. And my most appreciated performance is also Finding Fanny by the reviewers. that is a certain sensibility and a certain regard that they have for certain kind of cinema. You have to also keep the audience in mind when you review a film. Sometimes that gets missed. So it becomes very intimate and personal. मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि आपको ऐसी पिक्चर बनानी चाहिए थी. अरे नहीं बनाई भाई, हमने जो पिक्चर बनाई है वो देश के आवाम के लिए बनाई है. आप उस नजर से देख के रिव्यू देंगे, आई अप्रिशिएट इट. देर आर सम आई अग्री विद, सम आई डिसएग्री विद. इफ यू गेट पर्सनल, यार वी फील बिकॉज ही इज बाल्की ही शुड मेक अ फिल्म सर्टेन वे, दैट फील्स अ लिटिल सिली. ही इज ऑल्सो अलाउड टू हैव अ चेंज ऑफ हार्ट. ही वॉन्ट्स टू मेक अ लाइट सिंपल स्वीट फिल्म, वाई नॉट. ही डजंट हैव टू ब्रिंग अ सोशल चेंज ओवरनाइट विद द फिल्म. But I understand where the critics are coming from. Yeah. They have an opinion and a point of view about it because they have an expectation. The audience is seeing an entertaining film. They are not going with the expectation that it is Arjun ki picture or Balki ki picture. They are seeing Ki and Ka in that moment. They are enjoying 2 hours. And the audience verdict matters eventually in the bigger picture. See, these kind of films, obviously, you expect the critics to give it love so it does even better. But we have defied all odds. The film has done well because the audience has connected. So it's an exception to the rule. It's nice to be the exception to the rule. I think that gets remembered more often than the regular ones that do well because of the support. Sometimes despite not getting the support for a film like this, when it does well, you kind of realize that there's a very big audience in our country. There are a lot of taste palettes that you have to fill. And hopefully even the reviewers will reassess. Even we've reassessed. We've thought about what they said. Some make sense, some don't. Maybe even they'll reassess. Yeah, ki maybe we shouldn't be so harsh. It's a film at the end of the day. They get a little vindictive sometimes, which is silly because we are making a film for the audience.
You want the impolite response?
See, when you talk of critics, it's like 4 or 5 of them. I mean, it's not, majority of the critics have actually loved the film, and majority of people who are representative of the audience, that I think a critic is supposed to review a film for an audience, not a review a film for his, some guy at the Berlin Film Festival. You're not supposed to do that, number one. So I think there are a few critics. I don't know them personally, but what they've written, I sometimes wonder, one or two of them, did they ever come to Lintas for a job or something like that? Did I ever refuse them something? I went into all kinds of things. I mean, you must be a little out of your, see, I don't have an ego, that kind of an ego to say that whatever we make is so brilliant and all that stuff. But what you write needs to make some sense, even to a person who's who can be object, who a filmmaker is the least objective person about his film. Okay, but even if you try and be, okay, remove all that stuff and say, okay, let me try and do that, it doesn't make sense. And I think there are some people in this country who call themselves critics, and I'm very sorry to say that, but they're the kind of people who will see a Czech film, for a Czechoslovakian film without subtitles, and they'll say, what dialogues, what writing, mind-blowing. Beautiful. There's some all kinds of weird guys. Some guys like to see a brown leaf fall for 45 minutes and say, what poetry. Some guys like to see something. I have no idea what, where these guys come from, what mind space is there. I'm not here to make a film for them. If they happen to like the film that we make, fine. If the audience likes the film, that's what you're making it for. Because otherwise I'll go bankrupt making a film for these guys.
I mean, I would just like to, if he allows me to add to this.
I still one thing you want to add.
You know, there was... In fact, I don't know any critic personally. I don't even know their faces, unless in the mugs, except for Rajiv. I don't know many critics, except some of you here. And in those elite critics that you're talking of, who you call elite English critics, which are there, I just feel, you know, sometimes critics feel that only they have the power to kind of criticize somebody else's work. I think it's time the film industry also criticized the critics' work, because that's also work, you know? Like there was a film I remember in which this critic had an egg in his hand and he threw it at the camera and said, this was, you know, this is like anda, trash, this thing. I would really like to do it sometime to some of the critics, you know, because I have the same right. And this film is all about freedom of choice of people. You know, if the critics have the right, I have the right to criticize them. And I think they should understand that. And I don't think we should, they should also kind of introspect and check, because the audience has gone against them. Because, and that's the most important thing, learning for them too. It's not that we are right always. I'm sure that a lot of things they're saying is right. But a lot of things they're saying is absolutely and ghastly wrong. You know, it's sometimes they become very personal, and personal with people I don't even know their faces is like quite strange.
Listen, everybody has a right to an opinion. They've been writing for a while. They have their own opinion. They have their own take on cinema. I've always taken reviews in a certain regard, and then beyond that, I've always looked at box office because I'm a producer's son. So it's not ever been that I've been bogged down by good or bad reviews. You know, eventually the audience love keeps you going in this profession and nothing else. good reviews cannot make you get better films beyond a point. It's the box office collections. But yeah, like Balki sir is saying, you know, at the end of the day, maybe they need to also reassess sometimes. Like how we reassess, we put our hands up and say, "Yar, achha, is baar nahi chali. Hum samajh gaye. Hum agli baar better banayenge, koshish karenge." I remember the last one that happened was Chak De India. It got 1 star, 1.5 star on Friday. And Monday morning, everybody had turned to 4 stars. No, it's a fact. If you notice, there were a lot of people who came out not appreciating Chak De in the beginning on the first day. It didn't take a flying start either. And the film just grew and a lot of people put their hands up, which I feel is still fair.
There are some critics who have actually re-reviewed the film and they revised their ratings on this particular film. It happened. And hats off to them.
Somebody I think Gattu had to apologize for the film that he made called Fitur because he felt he had let down certain people. When a director is apologizing to people, I think the firstly, why has that happened? And secondly, at the end of the day, even a critic should then say, chalo, is baar humko samajh nahi aaya, audience ko samajh aaya, maybe we were wrong. That I feel is more important than us holding on to the stars that they gave or not. It's not constructive at the end of the day. I hope after this, maybe somebody says, chal, yeah, theek hai, we learned out of this. Next time, we'll be a little more open-minded about watching a film that we feel the audience will connect to. Because this, how can this emotion not connect with India? When you're watching this film, I'm saying, I did it only because I know, yaar, har Hindustani ghar mein ye kahani hai, ye baatcheet hoti hai. So, fundamentally, at a foundation level of the story, the connect will always be there. So then, why are they so against it? Why are they so upset about it? Because it's a conversation that we have at home, so it becomes boring. I don't know. I didn't understand some of the reviews,
there
but it's
some,
fine.
There's some guys who got really, you know, imagine one reviewer. I mean, he really needs to kind of watch a lot more films first before reviewing. He actually had the gall to criticize the camera work on the film, which I think is actually quite beautiful. And it's done by P.C. Shriram, who's possibly the finest cinematographer in the country. And if this reviewer can actually teach P.C. Shriram what cinematography is, he ought to be at least making a short film which runs. I mean, I really feel sometimes they get, and he said very personal things. Were they drunk in the focus? It's a technique that you adopt, you know, when you go out of focus and focus in life. He's gone off on a different tangent altogether. Was he drunk when he saw the movie? And I sometimes wonder, did they see the same film that the audience saw, a lot of you saw out there? And it's damn funny. It gets irritating. I don't read reviews. And these are things, just anecdotes that people told me. Okay, unless people message me the review or the link and all the stuff, I don't go out there and read it. And a lot of the reviews that I've read are the people who message it to me. But when people tell you this, it makes you very angry because somebody is being, not talking about the film, he's talking about other people. You know, so that becomes... And it hurts, you know, it hurts only because, yes, the audience has applauded the film, yes, the film has worked, but with the critic, with those, even those 4 or 5 critics' support, the film could have gone even one notch higher, okay? And so actually it's a crime. What you're doing is, you're occupying a space where you're actually influencing opinion and money. It's just not opinion. So you have a responsibility. If it's really trash, please tell us what is trash. They're the best reviewers who will tell you what is trash properly. Okay? If it's good, have the heart to say it's not my kind of a film, but I'm sure this is what will connect with people. If it's damn good and you're very happy with it, be happy, God's sake. Why do you have to say, no, I can't be happy in my life? You don't have to be like that. There are all kinds of people in the world, but this time I've really seen, and I'll give you another example. When Chini Kam first came, the number of people who smashed it to pieces. Okay, I remember...
Was it?
Yeah, they smashed it.
That's a very good sign for the film then.
They slammed it. And I take names. I mean, I have no problem with taking names. I used to respect Khalid Mohammed one hell of a lot, you know, before a lot of the other... He started writing a lot of other reviews which went out of gear. So his was the first review I ever read. The first review I've ever read in my life was his review in the Hindustan Times. I still remember that. He has torn it to pieces. Okay, like, you know, it is the most garbage piece of shit in the world, which is there. And the same elite critics, some of them, also ripped it to pieces. And it's so funny. I can understand, okay, I went through the same kind of angst and all this stuff till the audience liked it, till people kind of started liking it. Went through the same kind of thing. The funniest thing is today, when we were promoting this film, the same guys are interviewing me and saying, you know, Chini Kam was such a beautiful experience. And the same guys. And I was shocked out of my skull, and I was a little taken aback, and because the camera was on, I couldn't kind of say, hello, hello, do you remember this? I can pull it out. Just go to your own kind of stuff and check it out.
Can you ask him back?
No, I didn't have the presence of mind because, you're so tense. At that point, I'm film like, which I have to say the same thing. Okay, let me say, okay, finish your interview. You're in that mode. But it's so funny. How do you tell a person who's forgotten his own review? See, it's not whether it makes a difference or not. That's not important. You have a job to do. And a review doesn't, even if it influences one person, you're changing that one person's mind unfairly. Do it fairly. Please change people's minds. If it's bad, please say it's bad. But if it is good, if you're not in sync with the people, first of all, you shouldn't be reviewing. If you're not in sync with the audience, you shouldn't be doing that job. We accuse politicians, we accuse a lot of corporators, we only accuse all other kinds of people. These are all people who are actually swaying minds, who are all kind of influencing people. They have a responsibility. You can't do this. What if the audience had if the audience were hardcore fans and read every word of these guys' reviews and said, we will not see that film? What would have happened? Yeah, it's crazy, no? It's quite dangerous. So you can never say, no, reviews don't matter. Of course reviews matter. Of course all opinions matter. Everybody's opinion matters. Everybody's opinion influences somebody. The biggest opinion is the people coming out of the theater in the first show. Their opinion matters one hell of a lot. So many people have come and told me, I don't know what the review is. The review is completely the opposite of what this film is. People who read the review, hesitating to go to the film, went, because they didn't have anything else to see, came out and kind of actually a shock. So we all have gone through this experience this time of a complete, a shock on the...
No, sir, I've been through it in the past also.
I've also been through in the past, but I've been more affected right now because...
Yeah, maybe I'm numb to the thought because I've seen Two States was also not universally reviewed well. It was a mixed reviewed film. Gunde to khair. Ishak Zadeh was also mixed reviews. I just want to say today I meet people who loved Ishak Zadeh. Again, I remember even Habib sir had reacted because Do Duni Char and Band Baja Barat, which he had written, had got tremendous reviews. And he felt that why are they being so... Because there was again another thought about how women should be. And there was a lot of that conversation that happened during Ishak Zadeh also. But in retrospect, when you look back, it's a well-reviewed film because it did well. At the end of the day, I would like to focus on the positives. There are a lot of people who did appreciate the film. There are a lot of people who didn't, but they had valid reasons to not like the film. Like he said, at the end of the day, you're supposed to give the audience a point of view to go and see it or not go and see it. It's not only your own. I'm actually very okay with reviewers. It doesn't make me that much of a difference. I don't lose sleep over it, primarily because I know audience can outnumber them very easily when it comes to them liking something. And most films actually operate on that. Some films need the love. This film technically needed the love. Despite not getting the 100% love, it still has done this.
No, but there have been a lot of critics who've kind of got the point and who've kind of really loved the film and have said a lot of positive things about the film. In fact, funnily enough, the regional media and the Hindi media have been phenomenally, supportive.
The Hindi press, supportive. The press,
they've kind of, almost made it like literature to do this. It's just beautiful reading some of the reviews in Hindi. And it's crazy because for me, why I'm still talking about this point is, this was an important film to review well. Okay, it's not about box office or not. Yes, we can all say the audience wins, or the audience always will win. But there are some topics that you have in the state our country is in the situation we all face ourselves. There are some films that you have to be a little more responsible, not for the box office impact. Sometimes, in fact, these guys when they review it well, the films don't do well. Maybe that way it's good. But there are topics which have to be discussed well. For example, there's a lady who wrote, this film does nothing for gender equality. I never set out to do anything for gender equality. I set out to do for people equality. People are equal. People can have anything they want to do. If you've taken in your minds, this film is about empowerment of the female species or the lowerment of the male species, it's not about that. It's about people are equal. People have the freedom of choice. See the film for what it is. It's not a missionary statement. I'm not here doing a documentary. I'm here to do a film. So some people are really, they've taken this social mission in their heads and made another film in their heads and expect to see that film. Here somebody dancing and having fun. So it's crazy. sorry for this long thing, and you can move on.
आप फोन तो उठा लीजिए. बीवी बीवी खफा हो जाएंगी आपसे.
Few people, not critics. I mean, I hate the using the word critics. There are few people there. I don't call them critics. They are people. हो सकता है.
Possible.
Because I don't know these guys. Some of these faces, like I told you, I know only one or two people. But some of these people I have not seen before. Maybe when I really see them face to face and say hello, which year did we meet? What else? I'll know better. I don't think so. It was a joke. So nothing more than that. She was more angry than I was after reading, because she used to read the reviews. I didn't. She told me, "How dare this fellow?" I said, "Chill, chill. I mean, what's the problem?" So she loved the film. She went on telling this guy what.
Well, she was the first person to say, "Trust me, it'll do well. Trust me, it'll do well." Her and my dad. And
she's the, and both of them are the biggest critics. She's the biggest critic. If there is one scene in that Chini comes, she still keeps reminding me 7-8 years down the road, you screwed up that, screwed up that, screwed up. So they're big critics in life. So to get something not abused and not be reminded of your faults is itself a compliment from them.
नहीं मैंने कहा था हमने इतना प्यार ऑडियंस का नहीं एक्सपेक्ट किया था because the kind of film it is, ये concept रिजेक्ट भी हो सकता था बिकॉज ऑफ द काइंड ऑफ कंट्री वी लिव इन समटाइम्स यू नो यू कैन हैव अ कॉन्सेप्ट लाइक दिस नॉट एक्सेप्टेड एट ऑल. तो मैंने ये नहीं एक्सपेक्ट किया था कि 100% ऑडियंस प्यार मिलेगा ये कॉन्सेप्ट को लेकर. एवरीबडी इज एक्सेप्टेड द कॉन्सेप्ट. दे माइट हैव नॉट लव्ड द फिल्म, दे माइट हैव लाइक्ड इट, वो रेंज बदली है, बट ये कॉन्सेप्ट सबके दिमाग में एक घंटी बजी है जरूर कि हाँ यार ये हो सकता है या ये होता है या ये है. दैट वॉज माई सरप्राइज दैट वेहमेंटली द सपोर्ट हैज कम फॉर दिस आइडिया, दिस फिलोसफी, दिस थॉट. Because sometimes you feel, you know, कुछ लोग होंगे जो कहेंगे अरे ये गलत है यार ऐसे कैसे, they can have an effect. But thankfully, including the men, the women, all age groups, whether the young generation, the older generation, they've all appreciated the thought. That is something that makes me feel happy. See, putting everything else aside, I'm just very very happy that this film has done well, primarily because सब बोलते कुछ अलग करो, सब बोलते थोड़ा कोशिश करो कुछ different करने की, अब कर दिया यार. और genuinely audience ने बोला आप करो, हमको अच्छा लगता है. And I'm not saying this for any other reason, because if you see the track record of all the young actors in our generation, we've all got love for pushing ourselves and putting ourselves out there. So there are no rules for us. And when you do films like this that do well, then as an actor, I feel, yaar, chal, main aur risk lunga. Par badhava aap sab se milta hai. Kahi baar wo badhava nahi milta, par audience se mil jata hai. Is baar aap sab se itna vehemently nahi mila, mixed mila, which is fair. Wo bhi mere liye theek hai. Audience se is baar bahut zyada mila, to wo bahut achha hai. अगली बार शायद आपका भी ज्यादा मिले और उनका भी ज्यादा मिले, हो सकता है दोनों का ना मिले, तेवर भी आ चुकी मेरी लाइफ में. वो दैट्स पार्ट एंड पार्सल. आई हैव लर्नड यू हैव टू ट्राई एंड लुक एट द पॉजिटिव्स व्हेन यू आर एन एक्टर. फॉर मी दैट वाज द पॉजिटिव कि मैंने एक कॉन्सेप्ट पे विश्वास किया. आई सेड यस टू हिम टू लाइंस. ही सेड आई हैव दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, एवरी बॉय ग्रोज अप वांटिंग टू बी लाइक हिज फादर, व्हाट इफ अ बॉय ग्रो अप वांटिंग टू बी लाइक हिज मदर. आई सेड यस टू हिम ऑन दैट लाइन. आई डिडंट इवन आस्क हिम फॉर अ स्क्रिप्ट आफ्टर दैट, बिकॉज आई जस्ट बिलीव दैट दिस थॉट नीड्स टू बी स्पोकन अबाउट. And the country agreed with me, so I feel very, very happy कि सबने agree कर लिया इस बार, तो अच्छा है. मुझे लगता है मैं politician बन सकता हूँ.
But ideas aside, concept aside, I also think the film has worked because it's possibly Kareena's finest performance and his phenomenal performance, because I think for him to do this role, look at his size, and for him to be so gentle.
It doesn't sound like a compliment at all.
I'm just saying it in the way it is supposed
because
to be.
You're not talking about the area that matters.
So I'm saying for him to have such a controlled performance and be so sensitive and be gentle right through the film is an incredible thing, which not many actors can pull off. And coming back to my sore point of these 3-4 chaps, I think they saw animation. I think they saw two animated characters.
But sir, honestly, I've got liked by all the critics also, so I have no reason to complain at a very selfish level. I've got positive feedback mostly.
You've got only positive feedback. I'm only talking about the... See, my thing is, you're supposed to get positive feedback 100%. Why did you get 96%? So those four guys matter to me. Those four guys, I want to drill their heads.
Chalo, you handle them, sir.
What did you not see in Kareena that you've seen, as if you're seeing this kind of performance every day in your life?
Sir, somebody told me I slept through two states. That was a review. That was my one line given to me. This film is very good. Arjun Kapoor slept through two states.
He must have slept through the film.
I don't know, but you take it with a pinch of salt. I take it with a pinch of salt.
I never take it anything with a pinch of salt, because when he means it seriously, I've got to take it seriously. Otherwise, an insult to him.
Chalo, forget it. I can't win with you with this conversation.
See, I think audiences get educated, not when you educate them, when you tell a story, and they take out various points from that thing. They don't call it education. They call it, in the, like all our morals and life stories have been, life philosophies have been told to us through stories. We've not been said, this is a philosophy, mug up this philosophy. Somebody has told us a story and we've taken out a philosophy from that story all through our life. Same thing with films. Films tell a story and people get what they want to get from that film. Let's see. I don't know.
Sir, मैं अगले साल free हूँ वैसे. Half girlfriend खत्म हो जाएगी.
But it's actually a film that can have a story.
बच्चा हो सकता है ज़िंदगी में.
Yeah.
That's the next. I think they would have, it would have.
See, how would you answer that question when a character is saying, I don't want a child? See, if a character is in two minds of saying, I want a child, not have a child, then you can ask that question. The character is very clear, I don't want a child. So, that's a hypothetical question because I've written the character as a character that does not want to have a child. So, there is nothing more to that.
She might have a change of heart.
She may have a change of heart later on.
I'm hoping for the sequel.
And people do.
वरना सीक्वल में फिर से वही बिकरिंग नहीं ना इस बार कुछ नया होना चाहिए करने को इट विल बी फन फॉर मी टू हैंडल अ चाइल्ड एट होम व्हाइल शी गोस सो प्लीज राइट इट टुमारो एम आई फाउंड ऑफ चिल्ड्रन या आई एम फाउंड ऑफ चिल्ड्रन आई डोंट नो हाउ फाउंड देयर ऑफ मी बिकॉज ऑफ द काइंड ऑफ फिल्म्स आई हैव डन बट खतरों के खिलाड़ी डेफिनेटली बेनिफिटेड माय कनेक्शन विद द चिल्ड्रन फैन बेस स्पेशली द 11 10 11 12 13 ईयर ओल्ड्स So yeah, I'm hoping he gives me a film like this that'll get me even
in
more
the same age group. Of course, he's children love him.
This but I'm 14.
Same group.
नहीं पर वो क्या मुझे खुशी के आंसू आते हैं मुझे देख के उनको बिकॉज उनको गुंडे याद आती है उन्होंने गुंडे देखी है तो गुंडे में क्या मैं मारपीट करता हूँ तो खुश होते बाला 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 माँ माँ लेके आती है देखो आपका बहुत बड़ा फैन है रोना शुरू कर देते तो इतनी दीवानगी की आंसू आ जाते बच्चों के मुझे देख के अब सवाल नहीं और बच्चों को आई हैव कजिन्स इन माय हाउस एंड ऑल आई एम टू बी ऑनेस्ट ऑल जोक्स अबाउट आई एम वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ चिल्ड्रन सो आई विल बी एबल टू हैंडल इट दैट्स द ओनली रीजन आई वुड गेट मैरिड आल्सो इज टू हैव अ चाइल्ड हां अभी आप चार सवाल इसके बारे में पूछ सकते हो यार देख लीजिए जब हम ये करते हैं तो आप वो मांगते हो वो करते हैं तो आप ये मांगते हो नहीं बताइए क्या चाहिए आपको आई डोंट नो अबाउट द सीक्वल ऑफ गुंडे दैट यू हैव टू आस्क अली इफ यू कैन एवर फाइंड हिम अली अब्बास जफर हु डायरेक्टेड गुंडे आई एम एन एक्टर आई हैव टू प्ले ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ रोल्स अगर मैं उसी में बंदिश में रह जाऊंगा बाला या परमा प्ले करते करते तो फिर आई विल गेट बोर्ड ऑफ माय सेल्फ यू विल गेट बोर्ड ऑफ मी I'm quite happy experimenting and doing different kind of roles and different kind of characters and films. I don't know what it means that you miss my smile because this picture, mein, he made me smile quite a bit. Maybe not
smiling.
Maybe not in that evil. No, you miss the evil grin. I can give that to you right now. But I'm saving that for maybe some film where I need it. Again, Half Girlfriend for me is different. So every film is different. Maybe I'll come back to the so-called roots or this action image. In the coming year, in the coming couple of months, whichever film I sign, yeah. Let's see.
Yeah, like any child. Like any child, when he says I love trains or anything, there's no logic to it. So you just have a hobby and you kind of love trains. I mean, everybody. See, the reason also was. Besides the fact that I love trains, the reason was when a man decorates a house, okay, he's doing a job of what is normally associated with a woman when he's doing it, but doesn't mean he has to do flowers and pink clothes and pink curtains and everything. He's a man. So when a man designs a house, he'll do something which is a little quirky, which is more childish than more this thing. That's the kind of way his character is. So that's why I use that.
There's a TV show called Big Bang Theory. So if you see their house, they're geeks. So their house are... your house represents certain qualities or certain things that you like. It might be feeling like ये क्यों है? Because हमने पहले फिल्मों में hobbies कभी देखी नहीं characters की. सिर्फ काम से पहचाना जाता है, हॉबी से कोई नहीं पहचानता. So this will be shown a hobby of a person. That's why it feels that ये क्या है? Or it's
one critic actually who tried to find the metaphysical meaning of the train. Yeah, actually, like, it was a big thing. Saying, you know, what is this irritating? He called it some symbol of something of the train happening. It's a damn train, yeah. It's a train set.
चलो मैं घर जा रहा हूँ. मैं आज अच्छी-अच्छी बातें करने आया था. आप क्या पूछ रहे थे? हाँ हाँ मैं excited यार. अब क्या होगा? चेतन और मेरी कॉम्बिनेशन अभी दूसरी बार आने वाली है तो आई हैव बिकम लाइक अ सुपर हीरो फॉर हिम. जैसे आयरन मैन और इनके पार्ट टू पार्ट थ्री होते, मेरे ये पार्ट टू आने वाला है इसका. हाफ गर्लफ्रेंड कर रहा हूं. एक्साइटेड. चेतन इज समबडी हु हैज प्रूव्ड लकी फॉर मी इन द पास्ट. इट विल बी गुड. आई एम वेरी एक्साइटेड टू बी डूइंग द फिल्म.
ही इज आल्सो वेरी हैप्पी दैट की एंड का वर्क कम.
या नो, आई एम एक्साइटेड अबाउट द फिल्म, बट राइट नाउ वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट की एंड का. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट की एंड का. Of course I would. But you know, the characters that we play on Indian screen, the hero is traditionally a superhero. He sort of defies all odds. And I mean, I'm not talking about the conventional Hindi films, the so-called bread and butter films that we have. So when you do a gunde, there's an element of playing a superhero in that sense, because you're doing death-defying stunts, you're running on top of a train, coal mines are exploding around you. So you experience that feeling. Of course, I would love to wear a costume, hopefully with my underwear inside, save people and be a vigilante, or be somebody who has a mysterious past and who's decided to be a savior and a messiah. All those things do excite me, but it has to come from a very organic place. It can't just be, जैसे आजकल ये अभी परसों किसी ने पूछ लिया आप बायोपिक करना चाहोगे. अब पांच बंदरी इसका बोले ये नहीं, मैं भी करना चाहूंगा अगर मुझे कुछ अपील करेगा तो. सुपर हीरो फिल्म्स हैव ऑलवेज बीन दैट, दे विल कंटिन्यू, बट यू शुड ओनली डू इट इफ इट कनेक्ट्स एंड यू फील यू कैन डू इट वेल. See, like Mr. India is the quintessential superhero we've had in India. Now, my father made that film, but it's not like I can say I want to play Mr. India just because I want to do it. The director has to write it in a way that I suit the role also. That's also equally important, whoever the director is. Before you ask who is the director, I don't know. My father would know that.
See, I don't like to do the same thing again.
I'm very busy. I can't dub in so many languages.
But it's a film that's doing quite well in the South also. But I'm sure somebody will kind of want to remake it because it is a universal subject. I'm sure somebody will want to remake it.
Aap bana lijiye.
See, it's a difficult question because I think, see, in Tamil, the idea of the very logic that we've used in Hindi, in Tamil, the way they look at heroes is very, very different. In Telugu, the way they look at the heroes is very, very different. So each area, it will be a very different kind of a person.
Sir, why can't I go in all languages and play this role?
You just don't have the time.
Sir, I'll take my time.
You got half.
I don't want to dump the film.
You're very busy with half girlfriend, Gunde 2, and what is the other one? What are the other ones?
Pressure's increased in terms of that pressure is always there. I think that's good because you want to outdo, you want to grow with every film, you want to get better, you don't want to rest on your laurels. At least I don't. The pressure is always there for performance, but I enjoy it. I love doing this. So, yet simple si cheez hai, picture chal gayi, ab mujhe mauka milega, I'll be able to push myself and do different kinds of roles. I don't have to overthink myself because the film is not a failure. When films fail, now you question even your own self. Every actor goes through that phase where you question your choices. You suddenly need support and help from other people telling you whether it's right or wrong. At least I'm solidly based now in a place where I can again start choosing films on my own merit. I went through a phase where even I was a bit confused. Yeah, maybe Tevar didn't work, so what happened? But I chose this on impulse. And I'm glad my impulse worked. So at least now I know the pressure is there to deliver good performances. I'll always perform. Utna confidence mujhe apne aap pe, I'll keep getting better. I'll push myself. I'll take chances. But now at least I know the audience is there to watch me when I'm taking these chances, which is very important for me. That's what I feel happy about. How much? One sec. She's also asking. You're also asking. She's also asking. Teen sawal. Pehle aap. Not too much, because I'm a very boring person, and if you look at me as a person, it's I'm not Parma, I'm not Bala, I'm not Kabir also, the only thing I can or Krish, I'm not, the only thing I can relate to where Kabir is concerned is the emotional connect with his mother. I wish I was as patient as Kabir, I wish I was as understanding as him. I'm not like that. I think the only thing that kind of trickles through in every film is I have a sarcastic take on things, you know, my humor. The way I go about being witty, sometimes if I improvise, so those things, maybe there's a residue of Arjun in certain characters. Especially Two States, I'd done that. I'd kept that straight poker-faced, talking a lot. This one, I've actually done little goofy stuff like the Dharminda dance and all, small things that I've improvised. So that's me. I would do that if somebody said that line to me. Small things that trickle through, but not so much. No major trait. Yes, ma'am, you were asking? What is the best compliment I received from my family members? I mean, you know, when my father saw the film, he said something that mattered a lot, because that is what actually happened with the audience also. He said, this character is not real, but you made him real. Maybe he's the most perfect man. That's what he meant, is that he's so perfect for a woman that he might not actually exist in this form. But you made me empathize with this boy. You made me connect with a guy who's not real in that sense. Actually, you should be questioning, aisa koi ho nahi sakta, but you're saying, nahi, aisa hai, bichara. So that is something that stayed with me, and that is actually something even a lot of audience members said to me. Yes. Aapne Sonam ko lady bola hai? कि आप सोनम से मिली हो? सोनम लेडी है? नो नो या वूमन करेक्ट नो आई एम जस्ट जोकिंग यार क्या 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 नहीं मैं उनका जवाब दे दूं फिर आपके पास आता हूँ आपने मुझे लफंगा बोला हाँ नहीं नहीं माय रिया लव्ड इट सोनम केम आउट एंड शी हग्ड मी एंड शी सेड आई एम सो प्राउड ऑफ यू फॉर डूइंग दिस फिल्म Anshula read the script and she said it's as funny as what I'd read, and it's very difficult to pull that off. Normally when you read it the first time it's funnier than when you watch it the second time, because you preempt. My chachi loved it, Maheep, she saw it, she loved it. Shanaya, who's Sanjay Chachu's daughter, she loved it. So unanimously I think women in general have connected a lot with the film, and my nani, my masi used to see it twice more. My nani saw it and she absolutely adored it. So the women in my family, and I'm sure in all your cases also, the women audience has genuinely, it's a story that was waiting to be told, nobody said it. So I think it just makes you feel, arey yaar, ye to hamare aage aankhon ke samne tha, kisi ne bola nahi. So the women have reacted very positively. Anshula ka jawab de diya. Aap kya mujhe lafanga bola rahi thi ji? Gunda bhi hu, lafanga bhi hu.
In fact, the best, actually one of the finest compliments came from Bebo's mom. You know, she had come with 50 women. To watch the, not women alone, 50 women and some other 20 men who came along, and they all came out of the theater, and he was not there in the screening that day. I had just come there after that. She was like, and she's a very sarcastic woman. She is very hard to please and she's ruthless. She doesn't give a damn whether it's your daughter, son, whoever it is. She just stayed straight out. If she saw me and she didn't like the film, she would have slapped me and gone. She's that kind of a person. She just came and said, this boy is a revelation. I said, you're joking? No, the first time in my life I'm speaking honestly. It's she's fantastic. And that daughter of mine, I have to praise her. I have to praise her. She was struggling with, now what are the words she's going to choose to make up for all the criticism that she's given to her all her life? She was struggling with that stuff. It was fantastic to see her like that. You know, to me, I think when close people who are not easy, you know, really honest people don't praise you. Like, I don't think a lot of close people will say you're great. They're the people who will criticize you the most. And when they struggle to kind of, they're truly touched by a performance and they say, how do I tell my daughter she is divine? How do I tell her that? It's a fabulous thing to hear.
ऐसा कोई कैरेक्टर मतलब जो मुझे कैसे पता कौन सा कैरेक्टर मतलब नहीं यार वो जो हॉलीवुड में कर रहे हैं उनको करने दो हम अपने बनाएंगे ना जैसे ऋतिक रोशन ने क्रिश बनाया आई एम श्योर देयर विल बी मेनी अदर सुपर हीरोज लाइक दैट विल गेट क्रिएटेड आई जस्ट लुक लाइक वुल्वरीन तो आई लाइक वुल्वरीन बट आई डोंट वांट टू प्ले वुल्वरीन ह्यूज जैकमैन इज वेरी गुड एट व्हाट ही डज चलिए आप मुझे लफंगा गुंडा बुलाते रहिए, मैं वो करते रहूंगा आपके लिए, जरूर करूंगा। मुझे सबसे ज्यादा एंजॉयमेंट ऑनेस्टली एज एन एक्टर, सब लोग बोलेंगे पागल हो गया बिकॉज एक्शन की इतनी बड़ी इमेज है मेरी, बट मुझे जेन्युइनली टू स्टेट्स और कियन का करने में बहुत मजा है और फाइंडिंग फनी करने में भी। इट इज सरप्राइजिंग बिकॉज मैं एक्चुअली मैंने जिंदगी में किसी को नहीं मारा है आज तक, तो ये जो मेरी इमेज बनी है मारपीट करने की, इट्स कंप्लीटली अगेंस्ट, आपको ऐसा लगता है? हाँ, इसीलिए टू स्टेट्स और कियन का चली, क्योंकि लेडीज को यही लगता है। देखिए करेक्ट है ना, आई लाइक डूइंग बोथ, बट ऑब्वियसली आई हैव रियली फाउंड माई ग्रूव बाय डूइंग दीज रोमांटिक कॉमेडीज एंड आई वांट टू कंटिन्यू डूइंग सॉफ्टर फिल्म्स अलोंग विद दोज इंटेंस वंस आल्सो। थैंक यू
अर्जुन। अर्जुन
जी, अरे माइक, अरे क्या, हाँ कैसे आप? आपने उस दिन अंडा पूरा नहीं खाया था जब मैंने बनाया था आपके लिए, एक ही बाइट खाया था, आई एम वेरी हर्ट। जी पूछिए
सर। मिसेस करीना कपूर खान इज नॉट हियर,
मतलब अगर है तो दिखाई नहीं दे रही।
नहीं, why?
She had a commitment today. She's gone to Bangkok.
Okay, so will there be any event like featuring you all?
No, there will be soon. There will be very soon. We didn't anticipate that we would need so many days in terms of doing a press conference or an event, etc. She had already given her dates away. In the coming few days, we'll definitely have another event where she will also be part of it for sure.
Balki, which will be your next film?
Sir, bata do sir.
Will it be Chachi?
Chachi?
You are using suffix and prefix these days for your films.
He's giving you a title, sir.
So probably it can be Bachcha and Bachchi.
Bachcha, Bachchi. Like he's giving you. Yeah, so,
just give me the script also.
No, that's you have to think about.
I'll do it. No, I don't have any idea. Seriously, I don't have any idea.
Sir, but I read lots of second films that you've already planned.
I have no idea where they. Again, was it from those four fellows?
No, sir. In the papers it was. And today somebody asked me today that other film that you narrated to me, maybe you're making that. They asked me about that one also.
Arjun, lots of keys here. Like, can we have a dance of yours with keys?
No, I don't think we should be dancing today.
Why?
नहीं, मेरी की के बिना मैं सब की के साथ कैसे नाच सकता हूँ? वो it's wrong. मेरी की आ जाएंगी तो हम अगले इवेंट में जरूर नाचेंगे, वो उनके बिना थोड़ा अधूरा लगेगा ना।
सर, आपकी तो कितनी सारी की हैं।
How do you know that bro? Have you been going through my phone?
No, but
नहीं,
like
करीना के बिना डांस करना अधूरा होगा, अगले इवेंट में जरूर करेंगे आपके लिए।
But I think so, this should be the moment. Like lots
आपको
of
आपको ऐसा लगता है मैं आपसे सहमत नहीं हूं तो नहीं होगा मोमेंट। अगली बार जरूर नाचेंगे, मैं आपको गारंटी देता हूँ, जब करीना होगी साथ में जरूर नाचेंगे। इतना नाचा हो यार, हील्स में नाचा हूँ, नाच के अभी कल भी नाच रहा था उधर जीमा में गया था, कितना नाचा हो गया यार, फिर पसीना हो जाऊंगा, फिर वही फोटो आएंगे कल।
चलेगा,
आज ढंग का लग रहा हूँ, फोटो तो खिंचवा लेना दो।